Not many people will tell you this, but it's actually possible to improve your self-esteem.
It's true.
Yeah. To become someone that you are proud of and become more confident in yourself. It's just that if you find yourself surrounded by other people who are struggling with low self-esteem, it might start to feel like it's impossible. But you know what? It isn't.
So we want to give you four ideas on how to improve your self-esteem.
Exactly.
Number one.
Stop trying to get other people to like you.
Number two, comparison isn't your friend, you are your friend.
I like that one. Number two is good.
Number three,
develop your strengths. You know what you're good at.
And number four, work out what's important, your values, and stick to them. So the first thing is stop trying to get other people to like you. And the first thing you can do is to start impressing yourself. To basically do stuff that makes you proud of who you are and who you're becoming. It's kind of funny how far we'll go to try and impress other people. Some people will start showing off in class. Pio, remind you of anyone?
Yeah, or pretending to like a movie that they haven't even watched.
Or learning all the words to a gangster rap song they don't even like just to get someone else to like them.
If you only like yourself because other people like you, then that's a recipe for low self-esteem.
That's not a cake you want to bake, because when you put your self-worth in someone else's hands, they can take it away whenever they want.
Stop, stop. That's pretty powerful, eh? That is not cool at all.
No. One of the best ways to develop good self-esteem is to become someone you would want to spend time with.
Ask yourself, if I met me, would I want to be friends with me? See, as Kiwis, we don't like to brag too much or boast about ourselves, but it's okay to be impressed with yourself. Every now and then, take a moment to say to yourself, hey, I'm awesome. I like being me. I don't mind what everybody thinks. I am the man.
Or I'm the woman.
You know what I'd say? What? I am the super heavyweight champion of puberty.
Right. Or you could say, hey, I'm okay.
Okay, next up, comparison. Now, comparison is not your friend. You are your friend.
So one of the best ways to improve your self-esteem is to compare yourself with yourself.
What do you mean?
Well, I think sometimes we just forget we've improved or gotten better at something. I like to take notes, whether I jot it down on my phone or a computer or even in a book. I like to say something I've achieved or done or a goal that I've got. And when I look back, I'm like, oh yeah, I am running faster, or I have learnt something new.
You know what happens though, Petra? People sometimes focus on the negatives, but if you've got the positives written down, that's got to help. That's a cool thing.
Well, it is. It leaves you feeling better about who you are, and it helps you to remember. It's really easy to see the great things about other people, and we're often really aware about the worst things about ourselves. That happens online all the time. So journaling or jotting notes down can get you a good perspective. What if you are tempted, though, to compare your life with somebody's online life?
Yeah, well, you know, look, if you are scrolling through somebody's profile, you can see all the fun they're having, how good they look in the photos they choose to post, and how epic their lives appear to be. But that's because people edit their lives online. See, it's not usual for people to post pictures of their pimples or to write a status about how they failed a test or didn't make it into the team. Why, I hear you ask? Because online you can edit out all the bad, gross, boring, embarrassing parts of your life and just show off about all the best bits.
And we know this because we do it ourselves, but sometimes, well, you can forget that other people do it too. Let's face it, most people are trying to pretend like they have it all together, even Peel.
True.
And that's why it's so unfair on ourselves when we play the comparison game, when we compare the worst part of ourselves with the best parts of other people. That's a recipe for low self-esteem. Why not say to yourself, sure, my friend did better than me in that test, but hey, I am doing better than I did last year, and that's an achievement.
Yeah, I reckon you're right. And you know, I'm not as good a sports person as that guy over there, but I'm a better player than I was last season. So, I'm doing pretty good, man.
What about, I might not be the most popular and good-looking person in class, but I don't need to be. I'm a great friend.
Mm, mm. And anyway, my mum thinks I'm cool.
Mum, if you're listening, now's the time to give the double thumbs up and the wink.
You know, you can't really control other people, but you can control yourself. So instead of comparing yourself to others, just be proud of who you are becoming. One of the best ways to have great self-esteem is to make choices today that you will be proud of tomorrow.
Number three, develop your strengths. Some young people just struggle to believe that anything they do is worth being proud of. But I need you to listen to this. It's really important.
Really important.
Nobody is good at everything, but everybody is good at something.
Kia ora.
You have got some talent or skill that when you develop it, you will end up being awesome at.
Exactly. And everybody starts somewhere. You don't have to be great to start, but you need to start if you're ever going to be great. So try new things. Try lots of new things. Throughout intermediate school and high school, you will have heaps of opportunities to pick up some new subjects, sports, instruments, hobbies and activities, and you never know what you might be good at, mate. Have you ever tried cricket spitting? There's money in this. You could be a pro.
But here's the hack to working out what you're good at. Learning how to be bad at stuff first. Too many people don't like being bad at things. They feel embarrassed or they're worried that people will tease them. Or when they try something, it's actually way harder than they thought it would be. They end up thinking, I'm not good at anything. So they give up and they never work out what they're good at because they gave up. So in the end, they're not good at anything. It's a cycle of failure.
Seriously, if something is worth doing, it's worth doing badly while you improve.
That's true.
Every little disappointment and failure along the way is just feedback and an opportunity to learn and get better. It's totally okay, man, to be bad at something while you're still getting good. So keep trying new things until you find what you love doing.
In fact, if you want to work at Google, you can't be in management unless you can prove you've failed.
Okay, number four, values. Work out what's important, aka your values, and stick to them. There will be something you're good at, that's for sure, and it'll provide a foundation for self-esteem. It's always nice to have other people praise you and pat you on the back. No one gets tired of being told that they're smart or pretty or clever or handsome and that they smell good and are nice to be around.
But there is a secret to self-esteem and feeling good about yourself. More people need to know this secret, and it's got nothing to do with your choice of deodorant, hairstyle, or how many sports trophies you've got.
The secret part of self-esteem is when you can pat yourself on the back. And the most secret part of that secret is you can only do that when you know what your values are and actually live by them.
True self-respect comes when you can say to yourself, no one was watching, no one will ever know, but I made the right decision according to my values. I can be proud of myself. I am proud of who I am becoming.
So if you ever find yourself struggling with self-esteem, these things can really help. Having good self-esteem is all about being proud of the person that you are becoming. And you do that by doing stuff to impress yourself, not comparing yourself to others, developing your strengths and living by your values.
So here are a couple of questions for the adult. What are your family's values?
Good one. For the child, what are some values you think are really important to live by?